An intra-articular injection is an injection administered directly into a joint space. Intra-articular injections can be used for diagnostic or therapeutic purposes. As a diagnostic tool, it can be used in joints with a detectable effusion or in joints without a detectable effusion where you are unsure of the diagnosis. In these instances, you will aspirate and evaluate the synovial fluid. Alternatively, they can be used for relief of pain and inflammation in inflammatory arthritis, such as rheumatoid arthritis, gout, or spondyloarthritis, in non-inflammatory arthritis, like osteoarthritis, or non-articular conditions, such as tendonitis or bursitis. This is a list of absolute and relative contraindications. If any of the absolute contraindications are present, the intra-articular injection should not be done. However, if any of the relative contraindications are present, your clinical judgment should guide your decision. Rheumatoid arthritis, rotator cuff tendonitis, and frozen shoulder are conditions of the shoulder that will typically require intra-articular. Lateral and medial epicondylitis and olecranon bursitis are conditions of the elbow for which you may consider intra-articular injections. Decor veins tenosynovitis and carpal tunnel syndrome are common conditions of the wrist that may require intra-articular injections. Patients frequently present to primary care facilities with knee complaints. Osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis are among the most common. These conditions, along with knee pain syndromes, are indications for intra-articular injection. After completing the injection, the following steps need to be taken. Immediately apply pressure until the bandage can be applied. Use a pressure dressing if the patient bleeds easily. Advise the patient to rest and ice the joint for 24 hours. Warn them that pain relief as a result of the local anesthetic is temporary. Also warn them about the steroid flare over the next 24 hours and how to identify signs of infection. It is important that you document the procedure carefully. An important consideration when performing intra-articular injections are the complications that can arise. Iatrogenic infection, post-injection flare, local nerve damage, tendon rupture or weakening as a result of injecting directly into the tendon, systemic steroid absorption, and avascular necrosis of bone should be